Students, we are revising today the some matplotlib programs, and in order to know how to plot a chart and when the questions will come in the exam and how to deal with it. Okay, so how to see on the different situation the graphs can be made. Fine, so let us see if a few programs today. So let us open Python once. Okay, so when we do the matplotlib function, so you know how to import a matplotlib library. So the command is what? Command is import matplotlib. Okay, that is a command. Or sometimes you can do the from matplotlib also. That way also it can be done. So now let us see that how this to be done. Let it open once more. So you will be able to see. Yes, now it has been opened. So let us see now how this can be done. So we are doing one by one the few programs we have done. I have done out here for you. Okay, already. So this is a graph actually to be plotted. You can see out here how the matplotlib has to be imported. Okay, import matplotlib.pyplot as plt. Okay, that's the command I have used out here, and import numpy as np. That is required command, because this particular thing is sometimes required in this program also, though even numpy is not included in the syllabus at this time. All right, so here the two data has been taken. Actually the plotting to be done, and the axis to the main axis is like x axis 2014 15 16 17 18, and t1 t2 the graph has been taken in the same manner. Okay, so the thing is that plt.plot, you know how to do it here. T1 and color equals to g means green. You can change also here blue, red, whatever you want, you can do it. And the plt.plot ert2 color range. So whenever the two data has been given, on the basis of this we have to do the things. So suppose the marks one or marks two whatsoever, and this is the year the thing has been shown. Okay, so here year pass percentage and pass out percentage till 2018, that is the plot title. Okay, and plt.show is the main command, major command to show the plot. All right, now let us execute this program once. So run, I'm executing this program. So it is appearing how you see. Okay, so it's quite rightly the plot will be displayed to you. It takes time for processing a bit. Okay, but it will be displayed. Fine. So now these comments, once more you come over here. These are the attributes of the plot. So the, how these plots will be appearing, that is to be shown. Okay, color G, you can use the full green out here. You can use the color orange, you can use blue, you can use red, whatever you like. So these are the ones. So here the four comments are very, very important. I mean five comments. Okay, plot, then x level, y level, title and show. So these are the few things that you have to be a bit careful whenever you are you are plotting. And the command that you are using out here, that is import matplotlib as dot pyplot as plt. Maybe the graph has appeared at the background. Yes, now this graph has been shown. You can see out here from this graph, if you study this graph you can easily understand that where it has been gone. So 90 then 92, in that way it has been gone. That is a line graph actually, you know. What is happening out here? So here is a bit discrepancy out here, 94, then there is a bit drift. Okay, out here say 94, then 95 one has come out here, and then 97 has gone till there. Okay, that is the thing. So here what is happening, this graph was parallel with this one, 89. If it started from 89, then from there 91. Okay, then 94, then here when it reaches over here 93, then the discrepancy, you can watch out here, it has come down to 90, again it has gone up in 98. Okay, so that is what is quite understandable from here. Okay, so that is the thing. So from here you can easily understand that how these things are actually functioning. Okay, that is the thing. So this particular thing actually is for you. So you need to what you need to do is, so you need to draw the graph. Okay, and you have to see that how the, what is the nature of the graph in this particular program. Fine, that's what. So what this is the thing actually, we are displaying the pass out percentage in two successive years, that is few successive years, that means 14 15 16 to 18. All right, so that you have seen it. Okay, so now let us move us to the another program once. Okay, now we are going back out here. So new, and then we are opening a file. File is already here actually. We are opening another file out here. So this is the one. Okay, so here the font size attribute and everything has been used out here. The ticks also has been used out here, and plt.title, plt.show. So x level, y level, title and show, these four comments are very, very important, you know. Okay, so the thing is that here np.arrange and len level has been used out here. Okay, so the level has been arranged out here. Okay, that is the thing, in order, I mean. Okay, so and this has been, this has to be done. The percentage of marks achieved by student in class 12. Okay, that is the thing, that is the issue actually out here, who has got how much. So you can easily understand by seeing it. Okay, so now we are executing this program module once. Okay, so let us see, this program will be executed when you will, the graph will be appearing. Yes, the graph has been appeared. Okay, so let us see this graph once. Okay, so the Python to be here. Here this is the comparative study that can be done, and this particular thing you can save it. Okay, by using this particular save icon, or a save function is also available, so directly it will be saved. So that is the font size. Because of this font size, this has been printed in this way, a little bit bigger. Okay, so you have used the font size out here. That is the font size attribute is responsible for this, you know. That is the thing. So let us come over here. That is the student name is here. That is where you can see student name is here. Percentage of marks, this particular title has come over here. Okay, and percentage also has been shown out here. That is the font size 15. Okay, index level font size is 15. Okay, that is the x ticks, and the font size is 15, and rotation 30 is the attribute. Fine. So these are the few things out here. So np arrange, you can see out here, that is a len level. Okay, np index means what? Np arrange len level. So what is the length of the level? In that way it has been given actually. That is the index, you know. Okay. So you can see len level, you can see what is the length of the level. 1 2 3 4 5 6, and that is the 6 are there. So that is the length of the level is 6. So the graph also has been made, 1 2 3 4 5 6, and that is the thing. And every graph, every bar graph has shown is showing out here, plot out here, and easily understandable how much a student has been achieved in this particular exam. That is the thing that you are doing out here in this matplotlib graph. All right, that is the thing. So it is showing out here ticks and all out here. You can see the ticks. Okay, index level, it is accordingly, the thing has been printed. Okay, so the ticks has been given out here in this way. Okay, you can see out here 20 40 60 and 80 and 100, in that way. All right, and font size 15, rotation is 30. Okay, that is the thing. So now we are coming back to our another program of this kind. Okay, so that is also matplotlib function, but it is quite a lot of commands has been discussed over there. Okay, let us see the function of this one. So that is the thing. So okay, that is a comparison of visitors, visitors actually, that has been given. So here a range has been taken, range function. So 2010 to 2019. Okay, that is the range. That means the range will go till 2010 to 2018, because range function is a kind of function that always will stop, always will give you one less stop. That means 2019, if you have taken, it will stop at 2018. Fine. Then str year. Okay, okay, that is the thing. For year in range, that is a string function, str year. Okay, for year in range 2010 to 2019, and visitors has taken a tuple. This is actually a tuple, not a list. Okay, you know, that is the thing. So tuples, how could you understand? Because the tuples has been taken in a single bracket. Okay, and means like first bracket, I mean parenthesis, and this one and the list will be taken in the third bracket. Okay, that is a third bracket. That is the difference only. So we are just in arranging the years that has been generated. That will be generated, and bar width is 0.9. The bar graphs will give a coverage of 0.9 pixel. Okay, width, bar width, and plt bar index visitors. What are the contents of the bar graph? That has been shown out here, and the color has been given green. And plt x dot ticks and index with yes. Okay, that is the thing. That is the ticks, and the plt dot show will give you the what will give you the graph. Okay, that is the thing. So now I'm executing the module once. Okay, so it will be executed. Okay, you see out here, yes, it has been executed. See how the graph has been formed as for the thing. So I've so told you that 2018 the graph will be, so 10 11 11, it was very less. Okay, with the millions it has been taken actually. Okay, that is the thing. So 11 12 13 14, okay, 15 16 17, and this one is the last one is for the 18. Okay, so it is the largest. Okay, approximately so not approximately 5 million something, 5,399,000. Okay, that is the thing. So you can easily understand from here, this graph, from this comparison graph, the what was the number of persons that they have participated in this particular program. So these programs are quite useful for you. Okay, in order to draw the bar graph and plot whatsoever. Okay, so here one with the range function also it has been shown. Okay, so that is why you need to work with. Okay. So that is why these are the things that you need to work with. So years has been taken in a list. You watch it out here, the with the help of the range function that we have used out here. Okay, that's what. Okay, so these particular programs are very, very important for you. That is the thing. Okay. So length of years is taken, that is the index. Okay, otherwise what will happen, you know, these are the length, these are the number of graphs will not be formed, number of bars will not be formed. That is why it has been taken. So by keeping this particular programs in front of you, you can make some more data, some more matplotlib graphs and all. Okay, so you can make the bar graph, you can make the line graph, whatever you like. Okay, that is the thing. And that you have to know all that, how to do a plot this. So plt.bar is the command that is actually making the bar graph out here. So this program is quite useful for you. Okay, and definitely you do the the practical implementation. Okay, that is the thing. So now let us go once to the this particular program. Okay, the first program once. So this is the plot. When you are using the plot, you know, you are actually plotting the line graph, you know, that is the things. And when you are using the out here the bar graph, okay, that time what you are using, that is the bar graph that you are using out here, the bar. And the program that we have done already, that is this third program, that is the here also the bar you have used, bar index bar. So in two different programs have been given with the bar. Okay, so plt.bar and all. So here also the index and percentage we have used out here. And so index will be the axis and percentage will be the plotting. Okay, fine. And here that we have given the index, definitely we have given visitors, bar width and color. That is also possible. Okay, so color you can give out here. So whatever you can see your lower color equals to, so you can give your orange. Okay, orange suppose I'm giving. Okay, now if I'm executing this particular program, let's see what comes. Okay, so source modified. Okay, that is the thing. And let's see the graph. You see the color has been changed into orange. So anytime you can manipulate anything, so that doesn't matter. So these are the functions that you have to remember, what kind of graph has been given to you and what command you are going to use. That's why it is very, very important, you know. So you have to do this particular things. Now let us come to the one more program. Okay, out here. So that is the Python. Let's see, so I'll open it from here only. Okay, so now let us see what is the another program that is actually looking for us. Now that is the program. Yes, fine. Okay, so here some names have been taken. So we will change it out here. That is some this matplotlib has been given twice. I even remove once by mistake I have given. Okay, this is the coffee cups and coffee consumption. So the program is quite good. Okay, so almost like that only. So here the position and all has been given, where it will be bar graph. Okay, set ticks, Y position, set YT cable, person. Okay, and you can change these particular variables as well. And X level is cups, Y level is the set title is coffee consumption and plt.show. That to be used, that is very, very important. Okay, clear. Okay, so that is the thing. So some comments has been used out here. So let's see what is actually being done out here with this one. So some comments are not in your particular syllabus, but still you should know that is the coffee consumption has been given in this way. Fine. So this is the program. This is the program. This is the outcome actually of this particular program. Okay. Clear. So let us see. Once that is invert y-axis that we have done here, you can see the invert y-axis. Many comments are there in Python that can be applicable for matplotlibs and all. So these are the outcome of the different type of commands has been given. Okay, y position cups align is center. Okay, align is center's color is green, e color is black. Okay, that is the thing. C color means the text color is black. Okay, let's see. Now the thing is that as set y ticks y position, okay, whatever be the position is there, okay, and as six y tickable levels person and okay, whatever person as persons are there, that these are the displayed out here, okay, okay, all are displays out here, and finally this is the data that has been plotted. All right, so invert axis means you are actually doing the bar graph and in a not in vertically but horizontally. Okay, that is the thing, invert axis, and set x level is cups and set title is copy consumption. You can give type plt.title also, that is also there, because last programs that what we have used as commands, you see the various commands are there. Okay, not this one. Okay, I'll just show you. Okay, wait. That is the thing, not this one. This is the thing, plt.title. yes, plt.title also has been can be used out here, and here what we have used, we have used set title, s dot set title, that we have used. Okay, figure s, plt dot subplots, that we have used out here. That's why this is a kind of subplots that we have used, and that particular object we have used out here, set title, that's why. Okay, otherwise direct graph you can use plt dot title. So these many comments I have shown out here. So anyway, if you want to plot the graph, you can definitely plot the graph. That won't be a matter. Okay, so these programs can be given in the projects also, means your practical record file, that can be done. All right, so in that way, so you have to perform. Okay, so and whenever this program comes, you no need to draw the graph, you need to write the programs only. So you have to remember few things regarding this particular matplotlib functions, that is the you have to plt.plot you have to use if it is a line graph, and bar graph, that's commands are there, histogram, there is a program called command called hist, that also I will take once, the histograms with you. Well, that would also I will discuss you with you. Okay, but till now, and then x level, y level, title show, these five commands are very important. 1 2 3 4 5, yes, these are the five commands that has been used normally to plot a graph in matplotlib. So definitely what you do is that you must do the implementation of this particular programs that what I have demonstrated, and just note it down and practice yourself also by writing. Okay, that I must suggest you. All right, thank you.